Hello. I'm going to show you how I clean my ECIG. It's just a standard setup. I have an EGOT battery and a Kangertech EVOD tank. I'll show you how I clean mine. Seems to work out pretty good. I clean it about once a day so I can get the best use out of it so it delivers. Yeah, it's pretty dirty right now. And all you really need, paper towels, Q-tip, and some water. But first, what I like to do is just clean this piece good. Don't put a whole lot of pressure on it. Just kind of wipe around. Get all the excess juice off, because it does like to gunk up a lot in heat, or if you use it a lot, because it does generate heat from the battery. So it's good to clean it, don't know, depending on how much you use it. I use mine frequently, so I clean it about once a day. All right. Got that cleaned off pretty good. And give it a little blow. Just wipe it down again, because when you blow through it, it pushes more juice out, whatever's in there. So just clean it off again, and also on top. So all right, it's clean. And Q-tip. Take off a lot of the Q-tip. Yeah, that should be good. And you just want to kind of go through. Take anything out of this main chamber, because it will build up. Just go through the bottom. Yeah. It's pretty clean. And I'm going to go ahead and clean it out with some room temperature water. Because it will build up if you don't clean it. Alright, that's good. And just let that dry. Alright, it's been drying for a bit, but now I'm just going to help it dry a little faster by taking some paper towel, just rolled up, and just going along the inside of the tank. Yeah, you don't want it tight fitting. Leave it kind of loose in there, and just and give it a spin just to take any excess water out of the tank. Let's do it again. And yeah, if you clean it on a regular basis, It performs very well, so I recommend cleaning it. Not necessarily every day, that's personally what I do, but just every few days, give it a quick clean, doesn't take very long. Okay. And now I'll clean the inside of this chamber one last time. And if you do this with the Q-tips, don't go in like this with the full head of the Q-tip on there. Take some of it off. You want it kind of, barely on there. Because if you force it through, it's going to crack this piece and you'll have to get a new tank. But these standard tanks, these standard tanks are great. I've never really had any issues with them. So now, since everything's cleaned, gonna fill it back up. And this is actually from a local shop. They're called Vape Crazy here in my town. And this flavor is Wayne Crazy. It's good. It has it's the RY4, which is like, they call it, it's like a standard, I guess, tobacco flavor. But this almost has a butterscotch type aftertaste to it. It's got a really good flavor. And I'm gonna fill this up. And also what I like to do is do a blend. This one. This is actually from one in Nashville at Foghog Vapers. It's a pipe tobacco flavor. This actually tastes kind of like marshmallows that you would get in like a breakfast cereal. It's got a really good flavor. So I'll do a blend of both. And this is back on there good and tight. Yeah. Also be sure you don't get any juice running down that middle chamber. So and that's it, it's clean. It's really good when it's clean. But yeah, takes just a few minutes to do it. I clean mine once every day. Sometimes moisture can build up in here, so just use that Q-tip. Just barely running inside, and yeah, these things, if you clean them, they will work like new all the time. Keep your batteries good and charged, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Hope it helps you out.